Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. France have won their second World Cup with a 4-2 victory, a thrilling final against Croatia in front of a stadium full of passionate fans in Moscow and a TV audience of billions across the globe. A jubilant French President Emmanuel Macron celebrated wildly with his wife Brigitte while Russian counterpart Vladimir Putin watched on at Moscow's Luzhniki Stadium for the final game of the 2018 tournament. The match was disrupted in the second half when four people charged onto the field, with Russian punk band Pussy Riot claiming responsibility, leading stewards to tackle the hat-wearing pitch invaders. The French took an early lead when Croatia's Mario Mandžukić headed a free kick into his own net after 18 minutes, but teammate Ivan Perisic cancelled out his error 10 minutes later by firing in the equaliser. Antoine Griezmann restored France's lead before halftime from the penalty spot after a lengthy video review which ended in a handball decision against Perisic. Paul Pogba extended the lead just before the hour mark when he curled in at the second attempt after Griezmann had laid the ball off to the Manchester United player on the edge of the box. Star player Kylian Mbappe's long-range shot made it 4-1 before final first-timers Croatia pulled a bizarre goal back thanks to an error from French keeper Hugo Lloris. The highest-scoring World Cup final since England won the tournament in 1966 gives France their second title, 2 decades after their first when they hosted the competition in 1998. England's Harry Kane ends the tournament as top scorer with 6 goals. Scroll down for video. French President Emmanuel Macron celebrates wildly after France beat Croatia 4-2 to win the World Cup final. French players celebrate after winning their second World Cup title with a thrilling 4-2 victory over Croatia in Moscow. French fans watching the game at the Champs-de-Mars in Paris celebrate after their side's 4-2 win over Croatia in Moscow. French fans on the Champs-de-Mars near the Eiffel Tower watch their team's triumph against Croatia in the World Cup final. The jubilant French team celebrates after the 4-2 win over Croatia in the Moscow final gave them their second World Cup win 1-0. Croatia's Mario Mandžukić, bottom fourth left, scores an own goal during the World Cup final at the Luzhniki Stadium 1-1. Croatia's Ivan Perisic, number 4 shirt, fires in with his left foot to give Croatia an equaliser in the first half. 2-1. France restore the lead led as Antoine Griezmann scores from the penalty spot in the 38th minute of the final. 3-1. Paul Pogba scores at the second attempt to extend France's lead in the second half of the World Cup final in Moscow. 4-1. Kylian Mbappe shoots and scores to extend France's lead in the second half of the World Cup final in Moscow. 4-2. Croatia pull a goal back when Mario Mandžukić tackles French goalkeeper Hugo Lloris on the edge of the 6-yard box. The match was disrupted in the second half when four people ran onto the pitch leaving stewards to tackle the invaders. Russian punk band Pussy Riot have claimed responsibility for the pitch invasion during the second half of Sunday's final. The pitch invasion in the second half, in front of the watching Putin, saw four people dressed in suits and hats burst onto the Luzhniki Stadium pitch, with one reaching the center circle before they were tackled by police. Pussy Riot, the punk rock group who rose to global prominence with performances critical of Putin, which sent two members to prison for nearly 2 years, claimed responsibility for the intrusion. On the field, France took the lead when Antoine Griezmann swung a free kick into the box and Mandžukić, who scored the winner against England in the semi-final, diverted the ball past goalkeeper Daniel Subasic's outstretched hand. Mandžukić's unintended header was the 12th own goal of the World Cup, an all-time record, but the first ever scored during a World Cup final. Croatia were level shortly afterwards when Perisic teed himself up with his right foot and fired past French goalkeeper Hugo Lloris with his left after receiving the ball from Domagoj Vida. But just 10 minutes later France were back in front when Griezmann calmly scored from the spot after a protracted VAR decision to award a penalty for handball against Perisic. And Griezmann helped to create France's third goal after 59 minutes when he laid off Pogba at the edge of the box, who had his first shot blocked but scored at the second attempt. Kylian Mbappe put France 4-1 ahead after 65 minutes when he drove in from outside the area, before Croatia pulled a goal back when Mandžukić tackled a dawdling Lloris to score from inside the box after a back pass. Both teams were unchanged from the lineups that won their semi-final games. France beat Belgium 1-0, and Croatia beat England 2-1 in extra time to reach their first World Cup final. Croatia, a tiny Balkan nation of just 4.2 million people, has been caught up in football fever since they swept aside more fancied opponents to make it to the final of the tournament. Earlier on Sunday, Croatian President Kolinda Grabar-Kitarović gave her Russian counterpart Vladimir Putin a Croatian soccer shirt with "Put" imprinted on the back, while Putin presented her with a bouquet of flowers. Croatia knocked Russia out of the competition in the quarterfinals. Emmanuel Macron celebrates France's victory while Croatian President Kolinda Grabar-Kitarović watches on. Macron embraces Croatian President Kolinda Grabar-Kitarović wearing her team's shirt after France's 4-2 win in Moscow. French President Emmanuel Macron celebrates while his wife Brigitte and Russian President Vladimir Putin look on. Emmanuel Macron gives a thumbs up as he watches the game with his wife Vladimir Putin, and the President of FIFA Emmanuel Macron celebrates while his wife Brigitte applauds after France restored the lead with Griezmann's penalty. French players carry tricolour flags onto the pitch after their 4-2 win over Croatia secured a second World Cup title. France players celebrate with their adoring fans after winning the World Cup for the second time in Moscow on Sunday. France's Samuel Umtiti and Adil Rami celebrate winning the World Cup with a thrilling 4-2 victory over Croatia today. Presnel Kimpembe and Olivier Giroud of France celebrate on the pitch at the Luzhniki Stadium after their team's 4-2 win. Thousands of fans watch the World Cup final in the Champs de Mars underneath the Eiffel Tower in Paris on Sunday. French fans watch the game under the Eiffel Tower in Paris as their side won a second World Cup title with victory over Croatia. The French backroom staff celebrate after their side's 4-2 win over Croatia on Sunday gave the team their second World Cup. The match had to be halted temporarily during the second half after four people wearing suits and hats burst onto the pitch. One of the pitch invaders is tackled by a steward at the Luzhniki Stadium during the second half interruption to the final. A female pitch invader is dragged off by two stewards after the intrusion, for which Pussy Riot have claimed responsibility. Fans of France show their support in the stands during the FIFA World Cup final at the Luzhniki Stadium in Moscow. French fans carry flags and baguettes as they watch their side take on Croatia in the final at Moscow's Luzhniki Stadium today. French fans cheer in the stadium as they watch their side win the World Cup with a 4-2 victory over Croatia in Moscow. A Croatia fan watching the game in Zagreb looks dejected as her team falls behind against France in Sunday's final. French fans watching the game near the Champs-Élysées in Paris celebrate their first goal against Croatia in the final. Excited French and Croatian fans have descended on Moscow to watch their countries face each other in the World Cup final. Croatian fans unfurl a banner and cheer outside the Luzhniki Stadium in Moscow ahead of the World Cup final on Sunday. A Croatia fan joins her fingers together in the shape of a heart inside the stadium where Croatia will face off against France. A fan gives a salute outside of Moscow's Luzhniki Stadium, where Croatia will play France in their first ever World Cup final. A Croatia fan who came dressed in her team's colors strikes a pose at the Luzhniki Stadium in Moscow, Russia. French fans watching a live screening of the game in Marseille celebrate one of their team's goals against Croatia today. A fan of Croatia star Mario Mandžukić holds up a banner asking for the player's shirt inside the stadium on Sunday. Croatia's supporters cheer their team ahead of the 2018 World Cup final football match between France and Croatia. France's fans cheer their team on before kickoff inside the Luzhniki Stadium in the Russian capital of Moscow. Excitable Croatian fans cheer inside a metro carriage on the way to the World Cup final at the Luzhniki Stadium in Moscow. Croatian players celebrate after Ivan Perisic scored an equaliser 10 minutes after an own goal from Mario Mandžukić gave France an early lead. Croatia's Ivan Perisic celebrates with teammates after scoring his side's first goal during the final match against France. Croatian fans gather in the centre of Moscow, Russia, before their country's national team faces France in the World Cup final. Croatian President Kolinda Grabar-Kitarović gave her Russian counterpart Vladimir Putin a Croatian soccer shirt with "Put" imprinted on the back. Russian President Vladimir Putin presents a bouquet of flowers to his Croatian counterpart Kolinda Grabar-Kitarović. Vladimir Putin, right, greets French President Emmanuel Macron, center, and his wife Brigitte Macron, left, in the Kremlin. Russian President Vladimir Putin, right, offers flowers to Brigitte Macron, left, wife of French President Emmanuel Macron, center, during their meeting at the Kremlin in Moscow on Sunday. In Moscow, streets around the Luzhniki Stadium filled up from early as fans of the two nations, plus others lucky enough to have secured a ticket, converged on the 80,000-seater venue. Moscow's ornate metro, which has offered free rides to spectators, was again a carnival of color and noise as excited fans headed to the venue where strict security was in place. Elsewhere in the city, street walk cafes were filled with supporters clad in Croatian and French colors, plus those of other countries, enjoying a late breakfast or early lunch before heading to the imposing stadium, on the banks of the Moskva River. Outside the imposing hotel where FIFA officials and guests were staying, a fleet of black cars waited to take them to the venue while watchful police stood conspicuously outside. Croatian fans gather in Moscow's Red Square ahead of their World Cup final clash against France on Sunday. Fans cheer as they arrive prior to the World Cup final match between France and Croatia at the Luzhniki Stadium in Moscow. Fans enter Moscow's ornate metro, which offered free rides to spectators and was again a carnival of color and noise. France supporters carry a placard ahead of watching a World Cup final between their national side and Croatia. Grabar Kitarović has, herself, entered into the spirit of the occasion, traveling to Russia to watch matches and dressing in the colors of the national flag. At a Kremlin meeting, Putin congratulated Grabar Kitarović on the Croatian team's performance. "I'm sure we will see a beautiful game today," he said. Grabar Kitarović thanked Putin for what he said was the successful organization of the competition. Putin also met with French President Emmanuel Macron and his wife Brigitte on Sunday. The presidents of both Croatia and France will again be in the stands to support their teams along with pop stars such as Mick Jagger and a host of the game's legends. But absent will be Croatia striker Nikola Kalinic, who was sent home in ignominy in the first week of the World Cup after refusing to come on as a substitute in the team's opening game against Nigeria. He will likely forever be known as the player who sat sulking at home while his teammates wrote history for their country. A France supporter and a Croatia fan, both with their faces painted, pose for a picture ahead of the World Cup final clash. A Croatian fan makes a heart gesture with her friends inside the Luzhniki Stadium, where the match is taking place. A France supporter has her face painted with the French flag inside a heart and with Zabavarka, the official mascot of the 2018 World Cup. The tiny Balkan nation of just 4.2 million people has been caught up in football fever since they swept aside more fancied opponents to make it to the final of the tournament, which Russia is hosting this year. France remain the favourites to lift the trophy, but Croatia could upset them after beating England on Wednesday. Face-painted French and Croatian fans take a selfie outside the Luzhniki Stadium in Moscow, Russia, on Sunday. Meanwhile, both French and Croatian wags have jetted into Moscow to cheer on their men. Pamela Anderson is set to be in the stands in the Luzhniki Stadium to support her boyfriend Adil Rami. She posted a sultry black and white picture of herself on Instagram ahead of the match, writing, "Bonjour, big day." The 51-year-old Baywatch star cheered on her beau during France's semi-final showdown against Belgium in St. Petersburg on Tuesday. The Canadian-American actress and the 32-year-old defender are rumored to be engaged after meeting at the Monaco Grand Prix in May last year. Meanwhile, other excited wives and girlfriends documented their journey to watch the final on social media. French forward Kylian Mbappé's model girlfriend Alicia Ailes, last year's Miss France winner, shared videos from her flight to Moscow as well as a glamorous selfie. Pamela Anderson, whose boyfriend is French player Adil Rami, posted a sultry black and white picture of herself on Instagram ahead of the World Cup final and cheering on the team by writing, "Bonjour, big day, hashtag Alizelsbrilis." The former Baywatch actress has been sharing her support for the French team on her Instagram, writing alongside this picture that the World Cup has been so fun. France's goalkeeper Hugo Lloris' wife, Marine, waits for the start of the Russia 2018 World Cup final. Football match Erika Choparinia, who is married to France's forward Antoine Griezmann, waits for the game to start at the Luzhniki Stadium. France's midfielder Corentin Tolisso's girlfriend, Sarah, center, waits for the start of the Russia 2018 World Cup final. France's forward Florian Thauvin's girlfriend, Charlotte Pironi, is pictured inside the Luzhniki Stadium in Moscow on Sunday. Rachel Legrain Trapani, Benjamin Pavard's girlfriend, takes her seat ahead of the match inside the Luzhniki Stadium. Camille Tygat, wife of French center-back Raphael Varane, sits in the stands of the Luzhniki Stadium in Moscow, Russia. Steve Mandanda's girlfriend during the World Cup final match between France and Croatia at Luzhniki Stadium on Sunday. French midfielder Blaise Matuidi's wife Isabelle is pictured supporting her husband in the stands ahead of the World Cup final. France forward Oliver Giroud's wife Jennifer is seen wearing a flower crown as she takes her seat inside the stadium. Former Brazilian international Kaká, his girlfriend Carolina Dias and his son Luca arrive to the stands for the World Cup final. Pamela Anderson, pictured celebrating France's semi-final victory with a friend, is set to cheer on boyfriend Adil Rami in the World Cup final. Benjamin Pavard's girlfriend Rachel Legrain-Trapani, another former Miss France, also excitedly documented her journey to Moscow. The mother of one, who was previously married to former FC Nantes player Aurelien Capoue, shared a picture of her plane ticket. Later, she posted selfies of herself wearing a dress in the colors of France's national flag inside her Moscow hotel room. Despite his lack of playing time during this year's tournament, Florian Thauvin's girlfriend Charlotte Pironi will no doubt continue to cheer on France in the stands alongside other wags on Sunday. The 24-year-old has already taken to Instagram to show her support for France, with a sponsored post of herself in a blue outfit, captioned, "It's time for the final. Go Blues." The Monaco-born model's French grandfather Louis Pironi has played football for teams in France and Monaco and managed the Principality's club three times in the late 1950s and throughout the 1960s. French goalkeeper Hugo Lloris' wife Marine and their two children were already in Moscow on Saturday. She shared videos of her kids enjoying time in a swimming pool in the Russian capital, adding, "Good vibes only." Florian Thauvin's girlfriend Charlotte Pironi posted this picture of herself on Instagram on Sunday, adding, "It's time for the final. Go Blues." Benjamin Pavard's girlfriend Rachel Legrain-Trapani shared a selfie wearing a red, white and blue dress in her Moscow hotel room. French forward Kylian Mbappe's model girlfriend Alicia Ailey's left shared videos from her flight to Moscow as well as a glamorous selfie. Benjamin Pavard's girlfriend Rachel Legrain-Trapani, right, showed off her outfit in France's colors. Some of Croatia's wags took to their social media to share selfies as they made their way to Moscow. Raquel Mauri, the Spanish wife of Croatia's World Cup star Ivan Rakitic, shared a picture with her husband as well as some taken in Red Square. Duja Kalita Kar's girlfriend Adriana Durdovic, a lawyer and model, also shared her excitement with a picture taken with her sister in Red Square. Croatian winger Ivan Perisic's wife Josipa also shared her excitement with a picture taken in Red Square with her two children. And former wag Nevis Celsius has shown her support for her nation by posting a series of revealing snaps. "Whole of my soul with Croatian team," she wrote alongside a seductively posted picture of herself with the names of players written across her body. Raquel Mauri, the Spanish wife of Croatia's World Cup star Ivan Rakitic, shared a picture with her husband Raquel Mauri, pictured right, also shared pictures taken out and about in Moscow on Saturday. The former Playboy model was married to Croatian footballer Dino Drpic for 9 years, but the couple divorced in 2014. Moscow is basking in sweltering summer sun and the world's spotlight on the big day of the World Cup final. Croatia, a nation of just over 4 million people, are 90 minutes away from what could be a pleasant shock for them if they beat France to win their first ever World Cup. The inspiration of Luka Modric, the anchor provided by Ivan Rakitic and the attacking prowess of Mario Mandžukić will all be needed again if Croatia are to continue their fairy tale run and lift the gold-plated trophy. Croatian player Duja Kalita Kar's girlfriend Adriana Durdovic, a lawyer and model, also shared her excitement with pictures taken with her sister in Red Square. England fan pays £2,500 to see World Cup final by Sheikh Harbatia for Mail Online. An England fan has paid £2,500 to see the World Cup final. But unfortunately for him, it is France against Croatia and not Harry Kane and his team in the showpiece game. The builder, from Southend, Essex, forked out his cash on Wednesday morning, hours before England were defeated by Croatia and eliminated from the tournament in the semi-final. The football fan, who asked to be known as Gary, to protect his identity from his family and friends, said, "I do feel a right idiot. The ticket has a face value of $750 and I gave this Russian fellow $3,000 cash as I was worried prices would go up even more if England qualified for the final. I couldn't also live with being in Russia and not seeing England in a World Cup final. That would have been a nightmare I'd have had to live with forever. My dad had talked loads about 1966 and he'd seen England win the World Cup on TV and said he wished he could have been there as we might never win it again in his lifetime. I had that chance. I just needed England to win, but we couldn't manage that semi-final. But I was there for that and the atmosphere was electric. Although we lost, that's a game I'll never forget it anyway." The England fans were incredible and at the end the players come over to us and just soaked up the singing and saw we were proud of them. That was amazing. The proud England fan said he was further irked about having to spend an additional £2,000 on hotel accommodation for four more nights in a Moscow hotel to stay on for a game he had little interest in. It involves Croatia and that's the team that put us out. I am going to be looking at them as they sing their national anthem and thinking it could have been England. Still, it's the World Cup final and the next one is in Qatar in 4 years, which is a long time to wait. But judging by what we have seen England do here, we have got a good chance, he added. I have been here for 2 weeks and came out after we got to the quarterfinal and the Russians have been brilliant, so friendly and the weather has been great. There's a lot to feel good about. And the Bills will take care of themselves. Eventually, England captain Harry Kane gives a thumbs up as the team departs St. Petersburg on Sunday. The England team leave Russia on Sunday after missing out on a place in the World Cup final to Croatia. They will also have to dig deep to overcome the certain fatigue that has come with having been forced into extra time in the last three matches, winning two on post-match penalties. It contrasts with the slick progress of France, who beat Argentina, Uruguay and Belgium in the knockout stages to earn their status as favourites. They have had to deal with accusations of uninspired tactics, but coach Didier Deschamps has shrugged off the criticism and told his players to be calm, confident and to concentrate. There's nothing more beautiful, as a professional football player, than to play in the World Cup final, he said at the pre-match news conference. Deschamps could become only the third to win soccer's top prize as both player and coach, having captained France in their previous triumph 20 years ago.